don't deserve to be here. This is the meaning that I assigned to my life for 8 years. This is the meaning that kept me from achieving my goals, having a better relationship with my family, loving my friends, or having any values. Why am I telling you this? I'm telling you this because I want you to understand how powerful is meaning in our life. I want you to understand how important it is to assign conscious meaning to events, not let your brain give them automatically. But what is meaning? Meaning is when you create or construct a sense of reality. Cognitive psychologists say that we are meaning-making machines. We create pictures constantly in our heads, and then with those pictures, we put them all together and we create a movie. And those movies sometimes are called aha moments. And those aha moments create our reality. Those moments help us achieve our goals, influence our lives, our values, our relationships, basically everything that our lives is about. Let's see a little bit how our brain creates those images. I'm going to tell you. It uses three parts. The ventral stream of the brain, it's right here, on your side of your brain, here and here. The ventral stream is the part of the brain that assigns names to objects. So a chair, we know it's a chair because our ventral stream helps us. The second part of our brain we are using is the dorsal stream. It's up here, right up here in our head. The dorsal stream is the part of the brain which puts objects in space. So, let's do a small exercise. Look at the stage now. Look at me. Look at the jacket. Look at the screen over here, which is not working. Oh, you see? Look at the screen. Okay, silence. Look at the screen. And now, please close your eyes and imagine this picture over here. Me on stage, the screen right behind me, the beautiful picture on the screen. Open your eyes now, please. That image that you created in your head, that's the dorsal stream. Okay? This part of the brain created it. The third part of the brain, and the most important one, is my favorite, is the limbic system. The limbic system. This system is the one who creates emotions. It's the part of the brain that links emotions to events, to things that happened in our life. I want to tell you a story. I want to tell you the story of my life. I'm coming from Romania, and I don't know if a lot of you know, but Romania was under the communist regime for 60 years. We had the revolution in 1989. And when the revolution stopped, democracy came. Today was communism, tomorrow is democracy. And everybody, all the young people my age, like 30, went into business, went to find out businesses, to be entrepreneurs. They were no more handcuffed to a job, to the state. And those entrepreneurs were my parents. Right when the revolution struck, they went into business. They started building companies. I'm so grateful for having such amazing parents. But this quest of theirs came with a price. And the price was time from Horia. I'm not saying that my parents didn't give me an education. I'm not blaming them for nothing. But I'm just saying. So, with this lack of time, my parents felt that they have to give me something in reward. So they give me different things, objects, vacations, sometimes money. So fast forward, when I was 18, and I had some leverage on my parents, I demanded a car, because I was turning 18. It was cool to have a car when you turned 18. And I get a car, and I get my driver's license. And the best thing that you could do in my country at that moment was going on the boulevard with your car at 18. Oh, yes. And one night, on 8th of October 2005, I was cruising with my best friend Bogdan on the right side. I was the man. And I was cruising. At one point, a guy passes us by. And I look at Bogdan and I say, I can take him. Oh yes, I have a strong car. And I start driving. And driving. And driving. And I pass by that guy and I say, and I go driving. And at one point, a curve came. And once I was going to the curve, I lost my car. I went spinning, I blacked out, and boom! I opened my eyes, my head was shaking. I seen a pole over my car, and I looked to the right. Bogdan was unconscious. I pulled him out. I called the ambulance. We rushed to the hospital. I called my parents. He went directly into surgery. I was fine. But I didn't know what happened to Bogdan. I waited in the lobby of the hospital for 8 hours. And in one moment, the doctor came out. He came to us. And he said, Bogdan is dead. In that moment, I thought I hit rock bottom. I thought nothing worse can happen in my life. But I was wrong. After a period of time, I went to the same high school. And kids started yelling after me, "Killer, what are you doing back?" The teachers, a part of them look at me with doubt. A part of them look at me with sorrow. But a part of them judged me. 7 years later, my best friend from now gave me a set of tapes, self-development tapes. And I started listening. And I started understanding what is happening to my brain. When I started listening and understanding, is because in those moments when those kids were yelling after me, I started asking some questions. And my questions were, why me, God? Why wasn't it me on the right? Why am I not dead? In that moment, I created a meaning for my life. And the meaning was, I don't deserve to be here. I don't deserve to be on this planet. When I got those tapes, I started understanding that it gave meaning. Last year, I've been to an event in Dallas, a self-development event, and I started understanding more. But the best thing I did, I went into coaching. And my coach, an amazing person from Switzerland, One moment, one time, 5 months ago, asked me, Horia, don't you think it's time to let go of that event? Don't you think you paid your dues for that event? And I looked at him, what are you talking about? I'm over it for 3 years now. I understood what happened. And he said, did you? And he started digging, starting asking questions and digging and digging. And at one moment I said, what do you want from me? I don't deserve to be here. And at that moment he smiled. And I was so furious at him. And he said, can I tell you my perspective of things? And I said, sure, go on. And he said, Horia, what if God wants you to be on this planet? What if God chose for you to be on this planet? What if God gave you a second chance? What are you going to do about it? In that moment, my life changed completely. In that moment, I understood that I have a second chance to life. I was given a second chance to life, and that I have to live every moment of it. In that moment, in that highly emotional moment, he gave me another meaning, a new meaning, an empowering meaning. He didn't let my brain create meaning automatically. He created for me consciously. It was an amazing moment. I started following up that moment. I started doing things. I have a second chance to life. It's amazing. I'm one of the few people on earth who get a second chance to life. So I started understanding more and more, and I wanted to share with you guys what it really means to me. How to create meaning. How you can do it. Everybody can, not just me. The first step, catch yourself. Let me give you another example. Assuming you work for a boss, and he calls you to his office and says, when you enter his office, he goes, you stupid! Why did you do this, this, this? It's wrong! We don't do it like this here! And you... And before you got the chance to say anything, he goes, get out! I don't want to see your face! And you get out. You're shaking. You go to her office. And you sit there. You start asking questions. And asking questions. And doubting yourself. And fear kicks in a little bit. And that's the moment when you create meaning, consciously or automatically. You can let your brain create it. You can say, my boss's office means I'm gonna get yelled at. I'm gonna be afraid. Fear will kick in. Doubt. Or you can do it consciously. And you can say, okay, I screwed up. But let me see what I can learn from this. What can I learn from this? What can I learn from his yelling? Maybe he's trying to teach me something. Let me find out what. And you start searching and searching and searching and searching. Till you find a new meaning. And you find some things you learn about. And when you find those things, you assign meaning. My boss's office means I learn something. Doesn't even matter he yells at me, I will learn something. You're gonna say, Horia, but you are talking about me doing it, but for you, your coach did it for you. Okay? Go ahead and tell it to a friend. Hey, this happened to me. He yelled at me. This is the feelings I'm getting. What do you think? Maybe he will give you a good meaning of it. Maybe he will give you a meaning that empowers you. Don't be afraid to be vulnerable. Go to your best friend, ask him. He'll help you. The second point is when you find that meaning, that empowering meaning, regardless how you do it, You decide in that moment that that's the meaning you'll assign to that event. Every time you go to your boss's office, it's the moment when you learn something and you search for it. Your boss calls you, "Horia, come to my office." And I say, "Okay, what will I learn now?" Doesn't matter, he yells at me. I'm searching for what I will learn, because that's the meaning the boss's office has, learning. And the third one, I believe you know it. Take action on your meaning. Every time you see your boss, you look at him, see what he's doing. Your boss or your boss's office means learning. Learning. Focus on learning. And your brain will start focusing on that, because your boss, consciously, it's meaning learning. It's not automatically fear or doubt. So guys, for me, oh my God. For me, I don't deserve to be here. It's the past. Moments, not things, is the present.